I mean, just be yourself. And it's not easy. And guess what? Who you are can change. I'm Leslie Harrod, State Representative, currently serving House District 8, and I'm running to be Denver's next mayor. I grew up all around the world, actually. I was born in Nuremberg, Germany. My mom was an OBGYN in the Army, and she settled down in Colorado Springs, eventually, after many different stations. And I graduated high school in the Springs, and then I went up to Boulder for college. And so it was quite the journey for me, living in places like Korea and Texas, you know, very different spaces, but finally finding Colorado as our home. I was inspired by a teacher very young. My first black teacher was in the fourth grade. Her name was Miss Piper, and she really clicked for me that I could actually do whatever I wanted to do. Watching my mom as an officer in the Army serving this country, I always had a commitment to service. And then as I learned more about social movements, especially impacting black and brown communities, I realized that I had to be involved in shaping how not only communities are perceived, but how we perceive our power and use them. So I was very interested in that, which is why I went to school for ethnic studies, media studies, and political science, because for me, all of those things really came together. Thinking about Ms. Piper, my fourth grade teacher, I didn't realize until she told me and then continued to tell me as I got older and was no longer her student, that I didn't think as a black woman I could do certain things, you know? And I think about that as I think about places that black folks are or aren't, you know? And can we be legislators? Can we be executives? Can women break glass ceilings? And why are they there in the first place, you know? I credit all of that kind of shaping to both Ms. Piper and my mom, who showed me that we could do things differently. And I never thought I would serve an elected office in Colorado until Representative Rosemary Marshall said, "You will," and took me under her wing, you know? And I said, "But I'm black and I'm gay and, you know, I'm a woman and you're the only one serving." And she's like, "Great, it's your turn, you know, and bring people with you." That's a good question. Denver is creative. We are bold and we are on the cusp. Tenacious, for sure, and that came from Ms. Piper in the fourth grade. Bold, and you know, just this one's hard to put in three words, but just getting it done. One is definitely my mom, watching her struggle. But also excel as, you know, an OBGYN in the Army. I remember in Colorado Springs at Fort Carson going to the commissary, you know, getting groceries. And, you know, typically when an officer walks by, someone who's enlisted would salute them. And, you know, I remember very distinctly one day a soldier, he was white, instead of saluting my mom, he spit on her and said she didn't belong there. And I remember me and my brother, can you imagine, we're young and we're walking with her and this happens right in front of us. And she knew if she reacted in that moment, she could definitely be reprimanded. She knew the system that she was in, right? So she stepped back and she just said, "Who is your commanding officer?" And she got that information and she reported the man, right? And instead of throwing some scene, which at the moment I thought she should have, you know, she said, "No, we're gonna take care of this a different way. We're gonna have real accountability." And that officer was reprimanded. But we also learned a lesson, which was, she's had to go through a lot. That's just what we saw. Those are things that black women have to deal with that I don't think a lot of people really understand. In the moment, when we're faced with such aggression, such hostility, we have many different options. Sometimes it is to fight back. Other times it's to call out. Other times it's to step back and say, "We're gonna handle this a different way." Sometimes it's to just say, "You're wrong," and to have a teachable moment. But that weight and walking through the world like that every single day is difficult. We have affordable housing crisis. We've got a homelessness crisis, you know? We've got public safety challenges that we've never seen before in this city. And so we are on the cusp, and it's time for us to again redefine who we are. in the past, I think we've done that through creating kind of a creative vibe in the city, you know, leaning into the grit and the ruddiness of Denver. And I think we got to bring back that grit and that heartbeat.